For many, this is what the average day looks like for a person nowadays, constantly within range of their cell phone and usually texting, calling, or scrolling through social media, spaced out the environment around them. But only a select few are aware of how we evolved into instant communication and calling. We've somehow turned messages that would take months to deliver into ones that take milliseconds, and allowed us to see our loved ones without having to travel long distances. All visions of people of the past dreamed about. So, how did we get here?
Does this sound familiar? It's the ringtone of the modern day cell phone, capable of being heard anywhere you go. Whether that be at work, school, home, or on the bus, the ringtone of a cell phone is an everyday occurrence. In today's world, people have cell phones, varying from brands like Apple and Samsung. But first, how did it all start? In 1973, Martin Cooper worked up with AT&T to release the Motorola DynaTAC 8000X, demonstrating it in New York City. A turning point for the way people communicated, making it easier, and increasing the possibilities of who you can speak to in the world. More and more models of cell phones would be released by multiple companies, and in the future, cell phones would change a generation. Let's go back a little further, to the beginning of communication that wasn't through horseback and paper, the telephone. In 1876, Alexander Graham Bell, a Scottish-American inventor, patented and created the telephone. Born in Edinburgh, Scotland, and homeschooled, Bell was greatly involved with the idea of inventing. His father was a professor at the University of Edinburgh, and his mother was deaf. Through Bell's childhood, speech, hearing, and sound was all around him. His father taught about sound at the university, and his mother was deaf. This would result in his speech-related teachings in the United States. In 1871, Bell worked to create a harmonic telegraph, and in 1875, he and Thomas Watson were able to make electricity into sound. Similar to the release of the first cell phone, Bell was in a race with other scientists and inventors, and overall came out on top. He was able to patent the telephone, and the rest is history. Around a century later, Martin Cooper and his team released to the public the first cell phone. Before joining Motorola in 1954, Martin Cooper already had a master's degree in electrical engineering and was in the US Navy during the Korean War. Following his service, he worked at Teletype Corporation, which was part of AT&T, soon to be his enemy. During his time at Motorola, Cooper was always involved with their communication devices like its pager, two-way radio, and the first cell phone. The Motorola DynaTAC 8000X was similar to some of Motorola's devices in the past, like its walkie-talkie. The SCR536, made by Motorola, then called Galvin Manufacturing, was introduced to the battlefield in the 1940s. It was a handheld radio, or also known as a walkie-talkie. Walkie-talkies were extensively used during World War II, even though they were not as battle-ready. Some say the radio closely resembles the future DynaTAC 8000X's shape, with the same overall bulkiness and large size. Before the development of the first cell phone, John Mitchell, who was Martin Cooper's mentor at Motorola, made sure he knew that portable communication was important and groundbreaking. With the help of John Mitchell and many others, Martin Cooper was able to come up with the DynaTAC 8000X. From Alexander Graham Bell's telephone, to the ideas of portable telephones such as walkie-talkies, and eventually the creation of the cell phone, it reminds us how much advancement humans can have to take an invention and innovate it to change the world and its convenience to society.
Yeah, my name is Martin Cooper. I am the inventor of the cell phone.
Beginning in the late 60s and early 70s, the idea of a telephone that was mobile enough for a person to carry on their hands was starting to come into fruition. This idea became a reality when Dr. Martin Cooper and Rudy Krolop, both Motorola engineers, and the RACTAC team of even more engineers, proposed the idea of portable cell phones. In a David vs. Goliath-esque matchup, Motorola decided to go against the much larger Bell Laboratories, or AT&T. The Motorola team promised that they would have a functioning prototype within a couple of years, but they would need to work much harder and faster than AT&T, as they were put in a do-or-die situation.
Motorola spent $100 million. The company was only a $1 billion company. So between all of those things, people had to work day and night for 3 months just to put all those things together to make that very first phone.
Luckily, Motorola won over AT&T with their first functional prototype in 1973. And on April 3rd, Cooper took to the streets of New York City with his prototype.
My phone call that I made on the streets of New York on April 3rd, 1973.
According to Cooper, the brick phone had gained strange looks from past New Yorkers, as it was unusual. Ironically enough, the receivers of the first cell phone call ended up being AT&T. This victory allowed Motorola to develop the DynaTAC 8000X, which ended up releasing in September of 1983, becoming the first ever commercially available cell phone. While that was priced more appropriately for a Wall Street stockbroker at $3,995, it legitimized Motorola and allowed for more forms of portable communication.
The radio frequency they were using for this new phone had never been used before.
The DynaTAC was a stepping stone for these future companies to explore ways to improve and create their own versions. Siemens, being the first of many companies to produce their own cell phone in 1985, released the Mobile Telephone C1, resembling a briefcase being carried in the hand, marking the starting point for future phones to innovate, becoming more compact and convenient. In 1987, Nokia, a well-known competitor for the future of Motorola in the phone marketplace, released their own version of the phone called the Nokia Cityman 900. Similar to the DynaTAC 8000X, it was very pricey, with only the rich and wealthy being able to afford it. Because of this, it marked the beginning of the rivalry between Nokia and Motorola in producing better cell phones. Within the next decade, multiple very important innovations were introduced to the phones. The first 2G phone, the Nokia 1011, shrunk the phone sizes and antennas to make it more convenient. A decrease in phone sizes greatly benefited individuals, as they now were able to simply carry their form of communication in a pocket. In 1996, the Nokia Communicator 9000 was released, which was the first phone with a keyboard that included the QWERTY keys. In 1998, the Siemens S10 was released, with the first colors ever to be on a phone screen, which paved the way for the Sanyo SCP-5300, as it allowed its users to view images directly from the phone screen with colors, while also including a camera with a flash. Within this 20-year time span, it was mainly Nokia and Motorola competing against each other to make the most compact, convenient, and powerful phone, until a new company came into the phone world and took over the marketplace, dominating it for years to come.
Fast forward 30 or so years, a new evolution of the cell phone was released, the iPhone. But before the release of the worldwide enjoyed iPhone, however, was the start of touchscreen technology. It started back in 1965, but failed to become widely popular until 2007 because of Apple and their integration of it in iPhones. The first touchscreen phone, the IBM Simon, came out in 1992. It weighed about 500 grams, making it light and easy to carry around. People were able to have easy access to phones whenever and wherever they liked. The first iPhone was created by Steve Jobs, an American businessman and inventor who was best known for founding Apple Incorporation in 1976. He was also a marketer and manufacturer of electronic devices like tablets and personal computers. Steve Jobs transformed the company into a world leader in telecommunications with the release of the first iPhone on June 29, 2007, sparking an interest for newer models and becoming the most popular line in the world, with over 38 different models sold and 2.3 billion iPhones sold worldwide.
The cell phone is so important that in some countries, in Africa, for example, people have their only living in India. Their only living comes from having a cell phone.
The cell phone's popularity continues to grow at a rapid rate, becoming a necessity for people across the globe. With the cell phone, people are able to survive and thrive. They are able to carry out actions that could save lives by calling 911 or reporting crimes right from their hands. In education, the cell phone allows students to access information easily. The cell phone acts like a link for the whole world, allowing you to speak with your friends and family across the world through social media apps like Instagram and messaging apps like WeChat. The social connection that cell phones present greatly advances the world and its technology. Without Martin Cooper's DynaTAC, who knows where the world would be in terms of communication and advancement. As the cell phone continues to evolve through problems and solutions, Martin Cooper's first call with the DynaTAC was really a call to a successful world in the future.
The founder of Motorola, a guy named Galvin, he said, "Do not fear failure. Reach out.